When he's not hanging with his friends up north, this actor has more layers than a cake and is good at giving some ladies a double O, whereas others think he's more Sid James than James Bond. Are the knives out, or is it a quantum of solace for Daniel Craig on tonight's Hollywood Swingers?
That expert introduction means it's time for our favourite segment of the show, Hollywood Swingers, where we celebrate those Hollywood stars who have swung into music. This week it is James Bond himself, Daniel Craig. Paul, tell me about Danny.
Daniel Rotten Craig.
No.
Yeah.
What a good name.
Mm-hmm. But then it sounds like rotten.
I like it. I think it's cool.
Spelt with a W-R-O-U-G-H-T-O-N.
Love it. Daniel Rotten Craig.
Mm-hmm. He was born the 2nd of March 1968. It was a Saturday in Chester to art teacher Mum Carol and Dad Timothy, who was in the Merchant Navy before becoming a pub landlord.
Okay.
After his parents divorced only 4 years later and he moved to the world with his mum and his sister, Craig began acting in school plays from the age of six, as well as regularly going to the theatre with his mum. And by 1984, around the age of 16, he joined the National Youth Theatre and he moved to London, where he worked as a waiter part-time to fund his studies.
Okay.
While studying, and he toured the world with the theatre and the likes of Valencia and Moscow, he then went to acting school, where he graduated in 1991. 92 saw Craig make his screen debut with a small role in the movie The Power of One, but most of his screen work was in classic television shows, where he would star in odd episodes of things like Boone.
Okay.
Drop the Dead Donkey.
I love it.
He was in Indiana Jones, the Indiana Jones Chronicles, the young Indiana Jones.
I loved that show.
He was in it.
Amazing.
For one episode. And Heartbeat.
Who wouldn't want to be in Heartbeat? That's exactly. The only sad thing is that I've never made it far enough that I could be in Heartbeat or The Royal.
Mm. 1995 saw the actor return to the film screen in the Disney film A Kid in King Arthur's Court. He played the knight.
I didn't realise that was him. It's such a good film.
Serious? It basically was deemed an absolute stinker.
Yeah. Was it one of the kids from Home Improvements?
I think it's a kid that looks like him. I think it was one of them, yeah.
Yeah, because there was two.
The cute one. I think it was the cute one.
Jonathan Taylor Thomas did A Kid in King Arthur's Court, and the older brother with the big square head and the blonde hair, he did one where he got sent back to like Saudi Arabia and it was like a prince in Aladdin's court. It was great. I loved these films.
In any case, yeah, Daniel Craig was in that.
No way.
But it was a complete box office bomb.
Loved it.
But the next year was arguably the first big breakthrough in his career.
Mm.
He starred in the 9-part drama series, the BBC drama Our Friends in the North.
Yes.
The series was a massive hit. Even today, still regularly voted as basically one of the greatest UK television shows that's ever been made.
I referenced it in my dissertation.
Lovely.
I'd never seen it and I never watched it. I just looked up text.
But it's considered to have been the launching point of not only Daniel Craig, but
Eccleston.
Also the likes of Gina McKee,
yes.
Mark Strong,
mm-hmm.
and Christopher Eccleston. For Craig, however, the call of Hollywood was a few years away, and the actor instead starred in a number of kind of acclaimed TV and independent films, as well as the Cate Blanchett hit Elizabeth. 2001 saw the actor take a role playing the rival and love interest to Angelina Jolie in the video game adaptation Tomb Raider.
So bad.
Which Craig admitted that he took solely for the paycheck. Now amongst...
Well, you're not going, here I took Tomb Raider for the in-depth script and character development.
Yeah, well, you never know. 2002,
no, you do, because it was Tomb Raider.
Saw the actor star alongside Tom Hanks and the legend Paul Newman. Before you say a word, yes, Ashley, the guy who sold the salad dressing.
Thank you.
In the crime drama Road to Perdition.
I'm kind of annoyed that you've took that away from me.
Because I knew you were going to ask me that ridiculous question where you've
time.
Got legend of stage and screen, legend of the screen Paul Newman.
Salad cream man.
And that's all you'll ever see?
Is that the guy that made the salad cream?
In my head, I've got little boxes, and every box is a little label, and he is in a box marked salad cream.
Let's jump forward to 2004.
Mm.
And it was the lead role in the Matthew Vaughn film Layer Cake as the nameless suave criminal that has been cited as bringing Daniel Craig to the attention of the producers of one of the biggest film franchises in the history of film.
Harry Potter.
No, not quite. Having originally noticed his work in Our Friends in the North years earlier,
mm-hmm.
and now seeing him as a suave, well-dressed, gun-toting psychopath in Layer Cake,
right.
Barbara Broccoli was sufficiently convinced that he could play another suave, well-dressed, gun-toting psychopath. And so Daniel Craig was offered the role of James Bond.
Or Hams Bond, as he's known.
Yeah, in Spain, but he was initially very reluctant. With Broccoli having to woo him over a period of time.
Do you think that's when I saw them together? No, because he was already James Bond.
He was already James Bond. Yeah, you
James,
saw.
James, I saw, I gumped, as far as Ashley Gump, when I see celebrities round about, and I saw Daniel Craig and Barbara Broccoli sitting together having a chat in a bar. He was wearing a denim jacket, denim trousers, and a denim Baker Boy hat.
You have to have James Bond energy to get away with that, I think.
I'm going
to
tell you now, he has James Bond energy and he was not getting away with it. You look like the lost member of Bewitched.
Well, eventually the actor did accept the role of James Bond and he immediately found out why he might have been right to be hesitant. Unveiled to the press by speeding
this.
Down the Thames on a speedboat, he was hit
H&S.
With a barrage of press and fan criticism for basically everything. He wasn't wearing a life jacket.
He was wearing a life jacket.
No, he wasn't.
Okay, I thought he was, and that's why he got made fun of.
Oh, it doesn't matter.
I think it was because he was wearing a life jacket, and people were like, James Bond wouldn't wear a life jacket.
He was chewing gum. Bond doesn't chew gum.
Bond likes having stinky breath.
He was too blonde. James Bond, Millet, James Blonde.
Blonde.
He was too small. He's under 6 feet.
But some of the other Bonds have been short men.
No, none. He's the shortest Bond.
Is he? Mm-hmm. That must be embarrassing.
And
it's like a Russian doll.
He looks like Sid James.
A wee
okay,
bit.
I added that one in, but he does,
it does look
like
a
Sid
wee bit.
James.
But Sid James was handsome. Sid James was a proper looker.
Yeah, but not James Bond.
I would have... Okay, hear me out. If Sid James had got to play James Bond, it would have been the greatest James Bond ever.
Sean Connery's the best James Bond. Pierce Brosnan's the best looking James Bond and has the best James Bond look, but he starred in some of the worst James Bond films.
Sid James is the best not James Bond, but
you're
should have been
nonsense.
James Bond.
Anyway,
I'll take a shake and not stirred. And then Barbara Windsor is the Bond girl. I'm sad this didn't happen.
What would her name be?
There'd be something really filthy that we can't say on the radio.
The largest jugs.
Should be a German beer hall girl calling largest jugs.
Yeah. Now, despite public support from all the previous Bonds, except Lazenby, because he doesn't really talk about it, there were multiple internet campaigns to boycott Craig's first Bond film.
Why are we such bad people? We don't deserve
but
anything.
But we don't even know what we're talking about.
No, we don't. That's
because everybody
point.
Absolutely shut up. When Casino Royale was finally released.
And everybody loved it.
It was a massive critical
it.
Hit. It was also, to that date, the highest grossing Bond film.
It was one of the worst James Bond films.
Casino Royale.
All
I don't
of
think
them.
It's that bad.
No, but listen
the next
to me.
One,
listen
no.
to me. All of those Daniel Craig James Bonds are too gritty and all the feelings and the real life. Mm-hmm. I want to see Roger Moore in a car with a slide whistle going whoop as he leaps over.
That was too far, but I do.
No,
it should be fun.
It wasn't fun. None of his James Bonds
no.
were fun. I found them all really intense and really upsetting. And then there's
no.
the whole scene with the... We won't get into it.
Well,
the
you had Quantum of Solace. Oh, he sucks her fingers. What is that all about? Quantum of Solace mm-hmm. had not only a terrible name for a film, it had a terrible script,
yes.
it had a terrible theme tune.
Oh, we're being mean.
It still made a ton of money.
Right.
And already had people saying that Craig might be the best Bond ever.
Hyperbole. Next.
But this is probably what Daniel Craig was afraid of, as despite starring in a number of other films, including like the war film Defiance or Cowboys and Aliens, that was rubbish.
Great film, loved it. One of
oh,
my favourites.
It's terrible. It's absolutely atrocious, actually. What are you talking about?
I love bad films.
Or he was in the Western remake of The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo.
Terrible
completely
film.
Unnecessary.
Uh-huh.
People just saw James Bond.
No, that's a shame.
They had him parachute out of a helicopter with the Queen at the Olympics.
He should walk about the streets in his weird denim outfit because that really threw me off Bond for him. I see him now as just a weird guy in a denim
matter.
Suit.
Then 2012 saw the release of Skyfall.
Yes.
Made over $1 billion at the box office. It's double.
One of
the
best Bond songs of modern era.
Uh-huh. Double the amount of the first two.
Mm-hmm.
And his dark and tortured take on 007. Was lauded across the board. I don't understand. I'm with you. James Bond doesn't need to be this tortured.
No, I want somebody who's... I want what was written. I want a cocky guy drinking watery martinis and making really bad sexual innuendos to women in their workplace, which
nobody
I know is all
had
bad,
weird,
but I love
nobody
it.
Nobody had weird names.
There was no guy explaining how the laser was going to set off the thing that was going to release the sharks that was going to eat them in the tank.
The largesse de jugs. There was none of that.
Anyway, continue.
His next film wasn't until 3 years later, and it was another James Bond, with 2015 Spectre still making a ton at the box office despite polarising reviews.
My dad didn't like it, James Bond.
But Craig had had enough. He was done. 9 years of everybody just seeing him as James
Bond.
I'm
done.
And having the pressure of being the figurehead for what was pretty much almost its own economy at this point.
Yeah.
So him quit the franchise and publicly state that he would rather slash his wrists than star in another one.
That's a bit
mad. They paid him even more money to come back for another one.
No, he didn't.
But spoiler alert, the title of No Time to Die was a total lie because Daniel Craig made sure they couldn't get him back with even more money by making them kill James Bond.
Spoiler.
Definitively fire 20
My
million
dad doesn't
rockets
like
at
this.
Him, killed him, and at the end of 2 hours and 43 minutes that I'll never get back in my life, James Bond is no longer Daniel Craig. Daniel Craig is no longer James Bond.
That really upset my dad because how can they kill James Bond? Anyway, let's not go into
Don't worry about Craig, though. He's decided to get over being tied to one character in a franchise or making loads of money in adverts by playing another character in another franchise, Super Sleuth Benoit Blanc in the Knives Out series, one of which is just out this week. And then making loads of money dancing in a recently released advert for vodka.
It's not nice. Not a good vodka.
Plus Assange, as the French say. Plus Assange.
Plus Assange.
Plus Assange.
It sounds like you're talking about sausage, right? What's he singing?
Now,
I like Daniel Craig. I feel that we've came off nasty because we don't like the modern Bond either.
I have nothing against him, but I just
think nice guy.
The James Bond is too grim and gritty. It's too
That's
grim.
Not his fault.
It's his fault because he decided...
He never wrote it.
When he first came in as Bond, he was like, I'll only do it if it's more serious. He made it serious.
Right, what's his song?
Tonight's song. We travel back to 2006 in a film released just 1 month before Craig's first outing as Big Jim. Starring in the drama Infamous, Craig gives perhaps his only singing performance, but does this leave you thinking it's the pits or that there's a gold mine in the sky?
There's a gold mine in the sky far away. We will find it, you and I, some sweet day. There'll be clover just for you down the line, where the skies are always blue, pal of mine. Take your time, old mule, I know you're growing lame, but you'll pasture in the stars when we strike that claim. And we'll sit up there and watch the world roll by. When we find that long-lost gold mine in the sky, far away, far away, we will find that long-lost gold mine some sweet day, and we'll say hello to friends who said goodbye. When we find that long lost gold mine in the sky.
That was Daniel Craig, our Hollywood swinger, with There's a Gold Mine in the Sky. Here in the Ashley Story Show, we rank our Hollywood swingers on a scale of 1 to 100. Kenny Rogers roasters, Kenny Roger being the best and first Hollywood swinger. Well, let's first go to our scores, Paul. Paul, where do you sit in Daniel Craig's performance? On a scale of 1 to 100 Kenny Rogers roasters, how many roasters does it get from thee?
I'd love to make a 007 joke, but it was better than that. It was a 39.
Okay.
Was it great? I mean, it was just there.
It kind of had wandering star energy. It kind of had, you know, it was all right. It was plodding. Much like Daniel Craig's other performances, it took what probably could have been quite a fun song and made it dreary. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to give it...
He went serious when he should have went fun and camp. Which is funny now that he's the one, right?
That's all fun and camp now.
Who's complained that, oh, James Bond didn't really show people how fun I am. And it was like, you chose, this is you. Well, James Bond, you could have at any time said, let's put some more of the James Bond jokes back in.
I'm going to give him 20 Kenny Rogers roasters, and I think I'm being quite generous. He wasn't a bad singer, but I would rather someone with a bit more pizzazz and a less good voice than somebody whose voice is okay, but they lack pizzazz. So for this, for just its pizzazz deficiency, I'm giving it what I said. I've forgotten what I said.
20.
Thank you. Get in touch via text 80295. Let us know your score for James Bond himself. Daniel Craig, did you love it? Did you hate it? Did you think it was meh? We want to know. But we're going to have a wee palate cleanser. It's one of our favourite Bond songs. It's The Wings with Live and Let Die.
When you were young and your heart was an open book, you used to say, live and let live. If this ever changes,